Hey everybody, it's Second Chance, and today I'm going to discuss what lighter I took on the trail. And it wasn't this one, it was an electric lighter that is waterproof, that actually makes Star Wars lasers. This thing, why I do not like these things or matches, is because the wind, this thing, wind doesn't stop. But also the very cool thing, so even if it's not windy outside, guess what happens if it's wet, rainy, or you drop this in water? Check this out. Ah, cold. Okay. Nothing. Keep trying. Pop this one open. Boom. Works. I don't know. Which one would I take? This thing has never failed me, even when it was getting low on power, which I only charged it once or twice every 2 weeks. And so all it would do is just start flickering. It would still light stuff on fire. So that was really cool. It just flicker, and then all you do is just turn it around, and there's a USB charger thing right there. You just plug it in, it charges, good to go, give it like an hour, and it's set. This thing has been working all year, and it still is working today. So I will not leave home without it. So if you're curious how this thing burns, let's check it out. All right, just woo, look at that. Whoa, okay, that is awesome. Oh, okay, oh no, wait. Okay, that's why I had a bucket of water there. I totally forgot for 1 second. Okay, moving on. Maybe we won't show that. Also, when I was actually trying to impress Little B, I know I could not win her over with something like this. So I came with the Star Wars flame. She was very impressed. Call it my Star Wars flame. She was, wow, just totally blown away by that too. And all women love it when you talk about Star Wars. So this is a keeper. I don't know if you've read a story called To Build a Fire by Jack London. That story is a good lesson about hiking in extremely cold temperatures and hiking alone. If he had this, I guarantee you that story would have ended entirely differently, but it's a really great story. I would go read that too. But imagine if your hand is freezing, and what are you going to do if your hand is starting to ice over and all you have to do is push a button? So for me, I wouldn't go into the mountains without this. That's me though. I would definitely not trust matches at all or a lighter. This is definitely my go-to right here. If you found this video valuable or you want to see more gear videos, definitely comment down below. And if you haven't already, subscribe. It's like this little bell-shaped thing. It's over here or over here or something like that. Somehow that really helps me. I'm not quite sure why exactly, but if you want to check out more videos, it would mean a lot to me if you click that subscribe button. Thank you so much. Also, I got secondchancehiker.com going now. I have a gear list on there. Just click on the gear link and you can see a lot of the gear I have. And if you're interested in me doing a review of more gear videos, definitely tell me which gear you want me to do next. All right, thank you everybody. Bye. Airplane coming? It's the airplane.
Where is it?
I don't know, I think it's... Wait, there it is over there. Tons of, we're right next to an airport here, so it really messes up filming though. Why?